Moonology, Working with the Magic of the Lunar Cycles. Written and read by Yasmin Boland. For Olivier and Louis, I love you to the moon and beyond. The secret of making something work in your life is, first of all, the deep desire to make it work. Then the faith and belief that it can work. Then to hold that clear, definite vision in your consciousness and see it working out step by step without one thought of doubt or disbelief. Eileen Caddy, founder of Findhorn. Introduction. The moon is the Earth's oldest temple, holding the potency of countless prayers since the dawn of time. A bell whose ringing brings you into the field of the mother, where body and soul can quietly drink. Dana Gerhardt, Moon Circles. Would you believe me if I told you that the moon can be used as a fantastically simple cosmic timer to help you create the life you dream of? Well, it can. How do I know? Because it has worked for me and for hundreds or even thousands of my readers over the past decade and a half that I've been writing about manifesting with the moon on my website, moonology.com. And now, as you hear about and start to use the practices and information contained in this book, it will work for you too. You can become a powerful moon manifester. To use the moon as a tool to create the life you want, you simply need to become aware of the lunar cycles and understand the basic principles of manifesting. This book will show you how to do both of those things. If you've dabbled in manifesting but have found that so far not much has materialized, the information in this book may well be the missing link you need. It shows you how to work with the lunar energies to supercharge your wishes and dreams. Manifesting with the moon's cycles as a cosmic timer dramatically boosts our chances of becoming accomplished, conscious creators and deliberate manifestors. You don't need to be an astrologer to do this either. In fact, you don't even need to believe in astrology. Nor do you need to know any maths or astronomy. It's really easy to work with the moon without knowing too much about the whys and wherefores. The moon is up there nearly every night for us to see. We're connected to her and she is connected to our planet. That's all you need to know as a starting point. The secret is to make wishes and set intentions in tune with the moon's cycles. Over the years, I've received hundreds of emails from people letting me know about their success in manifesting their goals, thanks to their regular use of new moon wishing. And that success is what I'm hoping to pass on to you within this book. You will learn about how and why new moon wishes work, they really do, and how the full moon dovetails with and aids and abets that process. In fact, the work you do on yourself at the time of the full moon will be what stands you in good stead for manifesting your dreams at the time of the new moon 2 weeks later. You will also learn how to make the most of each new and full moon depending on which sign of the zodiac they are in. And you will discover how to deduce the part of your personal horoscope chart that each new moon and full moon is affecting. This information can then be used to predict what you can expect in the weeks afterwards. How the book works. I've organised the book into four parts. Part one is an introduction to connecting with the moon and includes an overview of the eight main moon phases. Understanding these phases, each of which has a certain rhythm, and the key things to do at each one will be a boon in your life. Once you learn how to dance to the moon's rhythm, you'll find that life flows more easily. It will be as if you've cracked a secret code. Part two is all about the new moon. That means new moon wishing, how to do it, and why it works. I've shown you why this is a practice you should perform every 4 weeks for the rest of your days. It also means knowing which sign of the zodiac the new moon is in. Armed with this information, you can start to work with the themes and energies of each lunation. It's a very powerful process, and you don't need to know any astrology in order to do it. Also, in the new moon section, I guide you through how to work out very quickly and easily where the monthly new moon is taking place for you in your personal horoscope chart. Each month, the new moon triggers a part of your astrological chart called a house, and I show you what you can expect as a result. You'll also learn how to use the new moon to improve your life by connecting with the archangels and goddesses, how to boost your chakras, and much more. The idea is that you can create, plan, and predict your life using the new moon as a timer. Part 3 focuses on the full moon. As well as being beautiful and sending down numinous moonbeams, the full moon speaks of heightened emotions, tugs of war in our lives, climaxes, and the opportunity to release negativity. In this section, I show you how to use the energy of the monthly full moon as she moves through each zodiac sign. We also take a look at the power of full moon forgiveness and gratitude, and the way these in turn power your new moon wishes. Plus, you will see how the sign the full moon is in can be used to support any efforts you're making to live consciously and in tune with the universe. You will also see how to work out in which part of your chart the full moon is taking place from one month to another and what that means for you. Part 4 looks at the daily moon. If you become a dedicated follower of the moon, you will start to wonder, where's the moon on a regular basis? This section will help you see what the daily moon means for you. You'll start to understand the energy of each moon day and you'll know how to use it. Along the way, I also introduce you to the eclipses, which occur in accordance with the new and full moon, and some things called the lunar nodes. When an eclipse hits your chart strongly, it can be life-changing. Trust me, I have seen it for myself. You'll also learn how to make a 12-month moon planner, so that you can work on yourself in practical and magical ways every month in alignment with the moon phases. So within 1 year, you will have worked on pretty much every aspect of your life needing attention. All this is presented in the simplest way possible. To make things even easier, where appropriate, I've included links to pages on my website where you can find further information or download worksheets. So climb aboard, we're off to the moon. Part 1. Why the moon is magic. What many deliberate manifestors don't realise is that starting the manifesting process at the time of the new moon dramatically boosts our chances of achieving our dreams. Chapter 1. Get in tune with the moon. Let me begin by telling you my favourite new moon wishing story. To do that, I need to rewind to when I was a 13 or 14-year-old girl growing up in the city of Hobart in the Australian state of Tasmania. In case you haven't heard of it, Tasmania is an island at the bottom of the world, to the south of mainland Australia. The only thing that stands between it and Antarctica is a whole lot of very choppy water and icy air. Trust me, I know, I've sailed it. Wishing on a dream. Back then, my main dream was to get out of Tassie and go and live in Paris, France. I put pictures of Paris on my bedroom walls. I read French poetry and I listened to French music. The first dish I ever learned to cook was quiche Lorraine because, well, it was French. At one point, I even managed to get my hands on a packet of Gauloise cigarettes. not to smoke them, but to burn them like incense in my room. As I imagined, I was a chic Parisienne sitting in a dimly lit Latin Quarter cafe listening to jazz. Unfortunately, my mother smelled them, thought the worst, and I was in a lot of trouble. Fast forward to many years later. I'd qualified as a journalist and I was staying in Paris for a week because a friend had offered me the keys to his flat while he holidayed in Australia. It wasn't my first trip to my dream city, far from it, but it was the first time I had visited as an adult and my first time there alone. As it happened, I arrived in Paris on the night of the new moon. So, naturally...
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.